Hello everyone, myself Gaurav Yadav, CS41, and this is my presentation on electronic paper display technology. So here we'll discuss about the architecture of the e-paper display, technologies used in it, advantages and disadvantages of e-paper display, challenges we face, and application of e-paper display. So e-paper is a revolutionary material that can be used to make next generation electronic display. It is just a technology designed to mimic the appearance of ordinary ink on paper. Unlike conventional displays, e-paper reflects like just like paper. It is capable of holding text and images, and it is also named as radio paper or smart paper. It is portable, reusable storage and display medium. Architecture. So basically, electronic paper display has two different parts, front plane and back plane. The front plane consists of electronic ink and back plane consists of electronic circuits. So electronic ink is made up of millions of tiny microcapsules. These microcapsules have diameter of the order of 100 microns. Each microcapsule contains positively charged white particles and negatively charged black particles suspended in a clear fluid. Here is the architecture of black panel layout. You can see the electronic circuit here. These are the technologies used in e-paper display. Girishon, electrophoretic, electrobatic, and electrofluidic. In next slide, we'll discuss these technologies. Gyrocon. The first gyrocon developed in 1970 by Nick Sheridan at Xerox Palo Alto Research Center. Consists of polyethylene spheres, which is a genus particle. The polarity of the voltage applied to each pair of electrodes then determine whether the white or black face is up. It is based on a thin layer of transparent flexible plastic containing a layer of tiny plastic heads, each encapsulated in oil, and it rotates freely. This is some pics to understand the gyronic technologies used in e-paper display. Electrophoretic technology. It has a titanium dioxide particles dispersed in hydrocarbon oil. A dark colored dye is also added to the oil, and it is placed between two parallel conductive plates. When the voltage is applied across them, the particles will migrate electrophoretically. When the particles at the front side of the displays, it appears white. So this is the basic scheme of an electronic display. This here is bottom electrode and top electrode, and the charges. Electrowetting technology. Electrowetting display is based on controlling the shape of a conformed water-oil interface by an applied voltage. With no voltage applied, the colored oil forms a flat film between water and hydrophobic. Hydrophobic means water repellent. When a voltage is applied between the electrodes and the water, the interfacial tension between the water and the coating changes. As a result, the stacked state is no longer stable, causing the water to move the oil aside. Switching is fast, low power, low voltage technology, reflectivity and contrast are better in this technology. Electrofluidic technology. Electrofluidic displays are a variation of an electrowetting displays. They place an aqueous pigment dispersion inside a tiny reservoir. The reservoir comprises less than 5-10% of the viewable pixel area, and therefore the pigment is substantially hidden from the view. Voltage is used to electromechanically pull the pigment out of the reservoir and spread it as a film directly when the viewing substrate. Hence, it takes in color and brightness similar to that of a conventional pigment on paper. Now let's discuss advantages of e-paper display. It has paper-like readability, low power consumption, it reduced eye strain, it is twistable, inexpensive, simple manufacturing process, and it's thin, light form factor. These are some advantages. Challenges we face are a method for encapsulation. An ink or active material to fill the encapsulation, electronics to activate the ink. Disadvantages are very low switching speed, electrochemically complex, very low refresh rate. Imprint of an image may be visible after refreshing parts of the screen. And these imprints are known as ghost images. Like you can see here, ghost image here. It has an image inside the image. Applications, e-paper display can be used to make e-books, smart card display, electronic newspaper, mobile display, computer monitor, electronic watch or clock, electronic shelf label. Researchers found that in just few years, this technology can replace paper in many situations, leading us to think of a truly paperless world. Thank you. Thanks for your time.